I have a secret to confess. Despite all the years of me telling you I'm Charles Wooley, I haven't been entirely truthful. That's because I'm really a MacGregor, a proud member of the infamous warrior clan from the Scottish Highlands. For centuries, we MacGregors have been bravely, and it must be said, mostly unsuccessfully, fighting to save Scotland from the hands of the English. So when I was invited to attend a clan gathering, I thought it'd be a chance to immerse myself in the romance of my ancestral family tree. What I found, though, was a much darker and unexpected history. The Scottish Highlands are everything you might have expected. Mystique, beauty, and romantic history. My name is Wooley, but follow my ancestral tree all the way back and it ends up here in the Highlands with the fierce warrior clan MacGregor. I've come to Scotland to attend my first MacGregor reunion. And it's a clan worth bragging about, considering it was once led by the famous Highland hero and Hollywood favourite, Rob Roy.
Oh well, the great MacGregor, come to hand at last.
I've read the centuries-old MacGregor stories of heroism and brave battles against the English. But the best man to really fill me in is Clan Chief Sir Malcolm MacGregor.
Good day, Chief. I'm very excited
Welcome
to meet you.
Welcome to the Highlands. Very good to see you.
Thank
here,
you.
All the way from Australia.
A lovely sunny day it is.
A lovely sunny day, as always, in Scotland. Come on in.
Thank you.
Sir Malcolm is the keeper of all things MacGregor.
And he used that at the Battle of Glenfruin in 1603.
It was a battle we famously won.
He is the 24th chief, born into the job and trained from early childhood. He was educated in England, but Sir Malcolm is a true Scot and a direct descendant of the great fighter Rob Roy.
I can trace my line right back to 1400. And
how many generations is that?
Gosh, that's 40-odd generations.
The great gift, of course, is Rob Roy MacGregor to the world, a great romantic historical story.
Well, he is a gift in terms of the romantic hero. But Rob Roy was a man of his times, and he was just as much capable of deception and skullduggery as anybody else.
You and I. And so Sir Malcolm informs me of a much darker version of the MacGregor history. A fractious clan often too ready to take up the sword against other clans and making enemies everywhere.
Why do I feel a sense of foreboding and a chill in the air in this place?
I think it's because this castle probably has the blackest history of any castle in Scotland.
Frank MacGregor is a clan relative. He's come all the way from Tasmania as the Australasian representative of Clan MacGregor. Frank's brought me to the ruins of Finlarig Castle, built by Black Duncan from Clan Campbell, our worst enemy.
In fact, the feud between the Campbells and the MacGregors is larger than any other feud between any other clan in Scotland. And the Campbells were particularly horrible to the MacGregors in this spot.
What happened here in this sinister-looking pit?
Well, this is known as the beheading pit, where noblemen and MacGregors and chiefs were chained into this pit and beheaded to the delight of Campbell guests as he entertained his guests upstairs there.
The MacGregor prisoners are held down here, and the hated Campbell is up there with his cronies drinking wine and watching the execution.
Exactly. And because the MacGregor's name was banned, it was lawful to do so.
In fact, from 1600, the MacGregor name was outlawed by the King of Scotland for nearly 200 years. So you might be a MacGregor today without even knowing it. Just like me, our mob became Woolies. If you didn't change your MacGregor name, you were a goner. How much was it like excommunication or a fatwa where anyone can kill you?
Well, it was very similar, and you could kill a MacGregor and you would be rewarded for it.
Be rewarded?
Yeah.
No questions asked?
No questions asked. I mean, it was in, like, the Wild West. I mean, the chiefs of Glangregor were wanted dead or alive.
Hunted like animals?
Hunted by dogs, by bloodhounds, yes.
But despite the persecution, MacGregors somehow survived. Today, anyone with the name MacGregor in their family tree can attend the annual clan gathering in the Scottish Highlands. There's English, French, Americans, Australians, New Zealanders, and even a family of Germans here. Just like Frank, they're all tartan tragics. Is this merely an obsessive hobby, or do you think folk like you make some kind of genetic contact with their past?
I believe something to do with Scots. It's in our blood that you just have a calling to go back home.
How did you feel when you first set your foot on Scottish soil?
It was amazing. It was just so different, so green, and the language, the accents, just loved it. I just planted my feet, and I think I remember going down and I kissed the dirt.
More than the dirt, I'm keen to find my ancestral castle.
Oh, here we go, son, on the bus.
Looking forward to it.
And today, we're off with fellow MacGregors on a castle hunt. But I quickly learn that the name wasn't the only thing we lost back in those brutal times. Blair Castle is one of Scotland's most magnificent structures.
Wow.
This is
the ballroom. Overwhelming.
Yes.
But in true form, the MacGregors never owned it. We were only renting.
Which is a terrible thing to say, but I don't have a castle.
Well, not every clan did have a castle, but it's better to look at your clan history and what the personalities did.
Well, despite the joys of dispossession, I must say that I actually want to be in a clan that has a castle. I admit it, I have developed castle envy. Fortunately, my Australian MacGregor, Frank, has found me a MacGregor castle. Come and have a look at it. MacGregor!
Hi, Charles. Welcome to your castle.
Frank, I'm loving Kilkern Castle. I already feel as if I belong here. I feel like it's home.
This is Kilkern Castle. Imagine the majesty of it back in medieval times. And in true MacGregor style, this castle saw many a fierce battle between clans warring over ownership. The MacGregors were the proud owners until they lost it to the dreaded Campbells.
We lost it?
Only a few hundred years ago.
Have I joined a good clan, do you think?
By the next day, I'm again relishing my new status as a MacGregor, marching with all the clansmen to attend the Lochinhead Highland Games.
In all my life in Australia, I've never marched in anything like this.
It's an annual event, pitting local clans against one another, just like the good old days. It's the highlight of the reunion. Finally, I get to catch up with the chief's wife, Lady Fiona, looking splendid in her tartan finery.
I'd never done this before. As an Australian Scot, I'd never put on the kilt and marched with a clan. I like being in a clan.
Do you? What did you get out of it? What did you feel?
I got out of it, I think, what football supporters in Australia get from having a team. That's the closest we get to a clan, a feeling of kinship.
Family.
Of marching with family. Yes,
family.
Yes, family.
You're in the heart of MacGregor country here, so you must feel at home.
So how many MacGregors are in France?
Frank looks right at home too. So does Englishman Don MacGregor. His long-suffering wife, Andy, puts up with her husband's obsession.
What's it like living with a MacGregor fanatic?
Look, the worst thing he could do as a husband.
He could be down the pub, couldn't he?
Well, that's what I said, or womanising, or gambling. So a tartan obsession, I think I can cope with that, definitely.
The Highland Games are in full swing, literally. Old medieval hammers are being thrown, sheaves are being tossed, and, of course, capers. Pipers are piping, the dancers are flinging. In the meantime, Frank is flat out organising the tug of war.
Yeah, who's organising? Do we know who's in it?
It's the annual grudge match between the MacGregors and yet another ancient clan enemy, the MacLarens. I'm starting to wonder if, in fact, we had any friends at all. Donald MacLaren is their chief.
I've got to go over and organise the MacLaren tug of war team.
Yes, well, we've got a really good MacGregor team.
Have
We're
you?
Going to give you a run for your money this time.
Have you got a...
Yeah.
This is serious stuff. The centuries of grievance to be settled here.
Forget all the stuff about stepping and pulling. We're not going to do anything funny against them.
Right. We need someone who's going to yell that. So who's going to do that?
I'm going to yell. I'll yell from the side. Then you don't.
And yell they did.
Take a straight. Take
a straight. The chief among the loudest. At one point in their battle to win, I was worried that we might reveal exactly what's under the MacGregor tartan.
As ho! 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 Ho!
It's a hard-fought MacGregor victory, and our tug-of-war soldiers are exhausted, but it's left Frank, the Australian MacGregor, wondering where his loyalties really lie.
That's great.
Are you an Australian first or a Scot first?
The funny thing is, sometimes I've thought, where do I want to be buried? I actually have a tug of war with myself. Do I want to be buried in Australia or do I want to be buried in Scotland? That's how the pull is so great. Like, I've got a question for you. That was your first. How did you feel?
Oh, good. I felt at one with my clan.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
I was really pleased that you marched with us.
I've got sucked into the whole thing.